Hey guys and girls, welcome back to another episode of Spintires, and today makes me exceptionally happy. For the first time ever, bigtmaxx25 has got lights on his truck. That's right, Quasimoto 420 has given bigtmaxx25 a bit of help with coding lights for his truck, and as you can see, we're not disappointed. bigtmaxx25 and Quasimoto 420 teamed up to release this Chevy 3500 HD lifted mud truck. Now, all I can say, guys, is wow, this thing is amazing. Now, I gave it a quick run through the flood map before, and got to admit, I was beyond impressed. Beyond impressed. This thing is probably one of the most capable high lifted trucks I have ever driven. Now, you guys know I'm not usually a big fan of the big high-lifted trucks because they tend to tip over really easy at speed. Not this thing. Not this thing. It defies gravity, logic, and by every single account, it is so much fun. Look at the body details, for example. This Chevy is great looking. Love it. The tail lights, suspension, the big rims. Now, you can't get any add-ons for this truck at this point in time, but don't be surprised if there isn't some coming up in the near future. But anyway, guys, what better map to show off the abilities of this truck than the flood? That's right, I'm going to take this truck from here, straight through the guts of the flood, right up the middle, all the way to the garage. Even though we can't unlock it because there's no garage points on this vehicle, we can still get there in record time. Check this out. Bit of engine knock on startup, like a Chevy. Just kidding, I'm gonna get hate for that later on. But check it out, four-wheel steering, so that's awesome. And this thing is not a slouch by any stretch of the imagination. This thing gets up and boogies. It really does motor along. And it's stable. It's not flipping over, it's not trying to, you know, spin on me. It's just incredible. Here we go. Straight into the mud, that four-wheel steering working overtime, straight through into the flood, and look at this. I think we're going to set a world record here for the fastest crossing of the flood in a 4x4. Look at this thing. It's just eating it. Absolutely eating it. Now, normally when I get to this fast-flowing section, trucks struggle. Look at this. It's just hammering. This thing's unreal. It's not tipping over. I've got full control. That four-wheel steer has been done beautifully. Here we go, straight up into the dry land. Now, you guys would remember this section here where most trucks die because the engines go underwater. Not this bad boy. Check this out. We'll go full submarine, and it won't even stop. Well, it might slow down, but it won't stop. Look at that. Just ripping through it. Unbelievable. This thing is wicked fun. In fact, guys and girls, I've got so much confidence in this truck. Oh, wow. That's the deep section that causes even the 8x8s to drown. Just rip through it. I've got so much confidence in this truck. I'm going to take it through the stickiest mud that I know of. And I'm also going to take it on a trail. That's how much confidence I have in this truck. So what we're going to do is we're going to take it onto the Wild Horse Falls map, and we're going to see how it handles a muddy, muddy trail. Shouldn't have any troubles. Look at this. Look at that. It's just so stable and so much fun. This thing is unreal. All right, let's take it onto the Wild Horse Falls map, and I'll see you guys in a couple of seconds. Hey, guys and girls, here we are on the Wild Horse Falls map as promised. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take this big bad boy and we're going to take it onto a trail that has some of the stickiest, ooeyest, gooeyest mud that I have ever come across. And we're going to see how it does. Four-wheel steer just causing it to become a little bit tail-happy. But it's not really ever out of control. Slam on the brakes. Brakes work good. Okay, we're going to take it off here. Hopefully it doesn't roll on me. I have never had a truck in my life do that before. go to these extremes and still stay stable. Oh, I'm getting too deep. Thankfully, we have winch points, which is cool. So let's just grab onto a tree and get this big boy out of the river. That is one deep hole. If you ever fall into it, I feel sorry for you. There you go. I occasionally do stuff up while recording. And it's been known to happen. Look at that for a view. Unreal. So let's take it through that icky, sticky, gooey mud that causes nearly every truck I've ever met to come completely unstuck. Well, no, completely stuck. Love the way this thing sounds. It sounds so nice. Throw a bit of mud on it. No worries. Now remember, guys and girls, this is the ooey, gooey, sticky mud that usually causes most trucks to have a complete breakdown in grip. What mud. Just stormed right on through. Look at that. Oh, I'm falling off the trail. What sticky mud, it just climbed right through. In fact, I'm going to do something I've never, ever, ever, ever done before. I'm going to take this thing right through the sticky clay. See how we go. Oh, wow. Not even fazed. This thing just walks through it. Not even bothered. Wow. I love this truck. This is the first time I've ever fallen in love with a massively high, overlifted mud truck. This thing is unreal. And it's got nothing to do with the fact that it's a Chevy. It could be a Ram. It could be a Ford. But the quality and the handling is unlike any other lifted mud truck I've ever driven before. This thing is unbelievable. It is so good. In fact, you might very well find this on my top trucks for top trail trucks Spintires, believe it or not. That's how much I endorse this truck. It's that good. Am I going to say it's absolutely unstoppable? No. Am I going to say it's the perfect trail truck? No, far from it. But is it one of the best lifted mud trucks I've ever driven? Hell to the yes. Alrighty, there we go, guys and girls. We're going to end the video right there saying you can download this truck by visiting bigtmaxx25's Spintires garage. So just jump onto the Steam Community Workshop and look for bigtmaxx25's garage page, and you'll be able to download this truck from there. This has been one of the most rewarding experiences in a big lifted truck I have ever had. This, by far, is the best mud truck, by far. Best handling, best speed, best looking, until he makes a Ram, that is. Alrighty guys, I'm going to leave it there and say, download this for yourselves, give it a go. Until next time, bye for now.